Today we will be continuing on the next part of the chapter of Chennai. We have been learning many things about Chennai. We saw that it is a city located in the southern part of India and facing the Bay of Bengal. We also learned that it is the capital of Tamil Nadu and the old name was Madras, and we learned about the climate, that it is on the coast, so it is warm and humid. Then we also learned about how it is having many government offices located as it is a capital city. Chennai is an important industrial and commercial center. It is a big metropolitan city, so number of different kind of industries and important center. It's an important port as well. Last class we learned about the culture and the people and the food of Chennai, and this is the Carnatic music, which is very popular in Chennai. Also the important festivals they celebrate. So today we'll continue with the next topic about Chennai. Today we will be looking at the famous buildings, places and the beaches. Let's get started. So please open your textbooks to the lesson Chennai, page 193, and you can read along with me. Famous buildings, places and beaches. Fort St. George is an important tourist attraction. Kapaleshwara Temple and Parthasarathi Temple are important religious centers and are known for their gopurams. It is a tall decorated tower located near the entrance of a temple. There are many old churches such as St. Mary's Church. The government museum in Chennai is one of the first museums of India. Other places of tourist attraction include the National Art Gallery, Snake Park, Gandhi Mandapam, and St. Thomas Cathedral. The Anna Zoological Park is the biggest in Southeast Asia. More than 170 species of mammals, birds, and reptiles are found here. Beaches of Chennai are the main tourist attractions. Marina Beach is the most popular beach in the region. Here's an information about Marina Beach. Marina Beach is the second largest beach in India. The VGP Golden Beach is popular with children because of its rides and toy train. Elliot and Covelong Beach are other famous beaches of Chennai. Here is a picture of the Government Museum in Chennai. It is one of the first museums in India, like we read now. And it was created in the year 1857. And also it's supposed to be one of the best museums in the country. There are a number of ancient artifacts and ancient icons. Also collection of South Indian musical instruments, jewelry and many other things. At the end of your lesson, you have been given a project work to find out more information about the Government Museum in Chennai. Let's read that. Government Museum is popularly known as the Madras Museum. It is a museum of human history and culture. and it is located in Egmore, Chennai. With the help of the internet and your elders, collect more information about this museum on the following points. When was it built? What is its significance? Which government department takes care of this museum? So just as a fun project, you can find out some information about the government museum using the internet. This is a picture of the National Art Gallery, which is also located in Egmore. And you can see its beautiful architecture. And this is also one of the oldest art galleries in India. Next, we learn about the Anna Zoological Park. This is the largest in the Southeast Asia. And also it's established in the year 1855. So it is the first public zoo in India. And there are large number of different species of birds, mammals and reptiles at this zoological garden. We have seen that Chennai is in the southern part of India along the Coromandel coast and facing the Bay of Bengal. So as it is a coastal city, there are a number of beaches. Let's learn about the famous beaches in Chennai. The Marina Beach is the second largest beach in India and it is very popular tourist destination. It is supposed to be 12 kilometers long. Then besides, there are also other beaches which are very popular, like the VGP Golden Beach, Elliot Beach and Covelong Beach. So these are the different beaches in Chennai: Marina, VGP Golden Beach, Elliot and Covelong. This is another famous building in Chennai called as the Gandhi Mandapam. This place is called as the Fort St. George. The Britishers first settled in this particular area, and during that time it grew into a major urban center and also an important port. And then slowly the city started growing around this area in the nearby towns and villages. And finally this city of Chennai became the capital of Tamil Nadu after India got its independence. This is the Raipon building or the Corporation of Chennai. What does the municipal corporation do? Municipal Corporation of Chennai provides the civic services and takes care of the administration of the city of Chennai. So let's revise the important points that we did today. We saw the Fort St. George, which is a very famous building in Chennai. We learned about the Government Museum, which is one of the oldest museums in the country. Also, the Anna Zoological Park is a popular tourist destination. Marina Beach and the VGP Golden Beach are famous beaches in Chennai. Marina Beach is the second longest beach in India. We also saw other beaches like Elliot and Covelong beaches. Now it's time for question and answers. Are you ready? The most popular beach of Chennai is Marina, Silver, Aqua, none of the above. Can you tell me the answer? Marina Beach, that's right. Which of these are popular beaches in Chennai? VGP Golden, Elliot, Covelong, all of the above. So the right answer is all of the above. Next question. Which of these are important tourist attractions in Chennai? Fort St. George, Government Museum and a zoological park? All of the above. So the right answer is all of the above. Well done. And with that, we complete this part of the lesson Chennai. And we saw the important buildings and the places, the beaches of Chennai.